Alright, welcome back to Deal Cream Discussing Cars and Anything, and this is the last and final video on the installation of a fuel pump in a trapdoor. So you can get to it next time. Anyway, I made these pieces. What I'm going to do, I'm going to roll these over, you know. Up there a little bit. With the eye. That's right. Okay. This is how I was going to do it. Set them up. Draw a line across. I'm going to put the heaviest one off here. A little ticker. Little ticker, hey. Little tick. Little ticker. They're all different lengths, but. See, as it goes out in the middle floor, chances are you're carrying something heavy you need to support. You know what I'm saying? So these over here. Now I'll take this and put this in. I got that brace. So I guess I can only go over. Now I got these self-drilling zinc coated pole barn screws. You got the rubber seals on. I got that brace going across here. I guess I can only roll so far out. No big deal. Keep her going. Oh, for the kick one. This is the kick one. So I got a heavy load in here. If that would happen. Now we're going to put offset a little bit. I can't go for the grease under here. Now, trout of yours. And we'll take it apart and we'll paint everything and put it back together, and then we'll caulk it up with some rough sealant and undercoat it. Should be strong enough to hold anything, and plus the heads of the bolts will be inside the rib, so if you slide something across here, hopefully it don't get caught, but if it does, it'll be mild. One more screw and then we'll take it apart again. Paint everything. Rust. Charlie horse in my leg here. Let's see now. Okay. Let's take a look. Let's fix this again. I think it's time to go get a magnet. Thank you. marking them. One, two, and three. There. Now we mark. Alright, now it's time to paint them. Wait, let's take them out though first, huh? Almost lost it. Gotta hold it, I guess, huh? Okay, one more time with the magnet now again. Now, this is the way I chose to do it, okay? Now, no warranty, no guarantee, no nothing implied here, but I've seen what I did. Now I'm going to go paint this all. I'm going to take a spray can and spray this edge in here that you can't see. Cool. Oh well, I'm going to spray this edge in here. This is raw steel. And I'm going to go spray those parts and then once they're dry, we'll finish recording. By the way, I just wanted you guys to see. See, I marked them. There's two, there's three, and one's over there. So. Yeah, in this Minnesota climate, you gotta make sure everything's all painted up good. Well, that can dry. Thank you. in there. Oh, this is all really roof cement. It's just like undercoating, but in a caulking form. I'm gonna caulk this whole sucker up here. No, it's removable with a little bit of work, but it'll be removable. If it shall go again, which it probably will actually, before the truck is done. There, how do you like that, huh? Whoop, whoop, there it is. Whoop, whoop, there it is. And we are done. And that's all she wrote, guys. Well, guys, please like and subscribe, and we'll talk to you later. Hopefully this helps you guys out. I used roof cement on there, so it's sturdy, you know. And I can go over that with a coat of undercoating if I want to, I guess. Or, I mean, bed liner. I don't think I got to go that route anyway. But, yeah. Should work for a while anyway. So take care, guys, and please like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next ones. This will be the final one now for the fuel pump. So, bye-bye.